Dear Eva, it took me a while to write because once I got started, I got a little, or rather a lot, carried away, and this got rather lengthy. I was born in Berlin in 1927. Both my parents were also born in Berlin. My father was an attorney, as was my mother's father. When Hitler came to power in 1933, my father's license was revoked and my parents wanted me away from it all. So my mother took me to London to stay with an English family in a suburb of London. They were an offshoot of the Rothschild banking family and eager to help. A nanny was hired for me, and while no one spoke any German, I learned English very fast and completely forgot my German. However, as my father had served in the German army during World War I, he had his license reinstated, and my mother came to take me back home. In 1937, the Nazis put my father on trial because former clients had gotten out of the country with some of their assets. In those days, the Nazis still seemed to require some excuse. I recall the day of the trial, when my mother and I sat with some friends at an outdoor cafe opposite the courthouse, waiting for the trial to end. We never returned to our house. My father was supposed to be free pending the verdict. He left the country by train that night, and my mother and I stayed with friends and left with only a small suitcase 2 days later. We reunited with my father in Amsterdam at the home of those clients who had escaped. My mother then took me to London, where I was enrolled in boarding school, and my parents went on to Palestine. A year and a half later, my mother came to pick me up. Obviously, my father couldn't practice law in Palestine, and life was very difficult for them. My mother spoke German, English, French, and some Italian, and knew shorthand, and she kept us afloat most of the time. I was sent to the local public school, where I didn't understand a word. I don't think I even stayed there for a week. Instead, I was given private lessons for a year and a half by a German ex-dentist who knew Hebrew and supported himself teaching Hebrew to adults. I then spent a year in boarding school. At 13, I was accepted in business school without an exam. They were impressed by my father and my fluent English. After a year there, at 14 and a half, I got a job with an attorney friend of my father's. I did his correspondence in 3 languages, and I did very well there. As a result of the war, my father got a job as a censor for the British government, and my mother as a typist with the British Army. And when her company was to be transferred to Cairo, Egypt, they recruited all their civilian employees to enlist as a special unit so that they could be assured of qualified English-speaking personnel. In order to persuade my mother to join, they offered to enlist me too. I was 15 and a half, but it was recorded as 17, and after abbreviated boot camp in Tel Aviv, our whole group was off to Cairo. We worked for the same company for the duration of the war. My mother was discharged after victory in Europe, but I wasn't discharged until the end of the war. I ended up as a sergeant, personal stenographer to the brigadier, while my mother remained a private. I occasionally had to march our platoon to the offices in the morning. I would have to take roll call, and my mother would have to snap to attention, and the men would be hanging out their windows. I did try to avoid that part. We did get to go home to visit my father for brief vacations every few months. Immediately upon discharge, I found employment with the British Petroleum Company in Haifa and at the same time worked for the Israel Intelligence Service. Jack and I met soon after my discharge from the army, and we got married less than a year later. He was a petty officer in the British Royal Navy during the war. He was also born in Germany, but his parents came to Palestine when he was only 11 months old, long before Hitler. During the Israeli War of Independence, he served in the Israeli Air Force, repairing aeroplanes such as they were. He was a trained mechanic before that. After the war, he opened an auto repair shop in Haifa, which he operated for almost 10 years. We left for Pasadena in January 1959 with our two daughters, ages 8 and 5. We followed a few Israeli friends. He immediately found employment and a year later opened his own repair shop. I found part-time employment as soon as the girls started school and later as a legal secretary full-time. I retired about 3 years ago. Jack was always interested in agriculture, and in 1979 we bought an almond and walnut orchard in the San Joaquin Valley, which he farmed himself, giving up his auto repair shop. We continued to live in Pasadena, but Jack spent most of his time working at the ranch, while I worked in Pasadena 3 days a week, and the rest of the time at the ranch where we had a small mobile home. As far as our daughters, Nurit graduated from the University of California at Los Angeles, UCLA, with a degree in geography, and not too long ago she went back to school and got her MBA. Dahlia has an art degree from California State at Long Beach and an interior design certificate. After you've gotten through all this, I hope you will tell me a little about your life. I'm very much looking forward to meeting you in person. Who is this I wrote to? To Eva Nesselroth. I vaguely remember.